Hello friends, I'm Pratibha, Assistant Professor of English at KLP College, Debari. Today we are going to discuss a very important question from the play, The Merchant of Venice, the importance of trial scene. As you all know, this is the most important scene in the play where the entire action of the play is focused. So today we are going to discuss it in detail. Before we start writing the importance of the play, importance of the trial scene, let us look at the background of the play. The Merchant of Venice is a romantic comedy or tragic comedy by Shakespeare. It has been put in both these categories by the critics. It was written between 1596 to 1598. We don't know the confirmed year. And it was published in 1600. The setting of the play is Venice or Belmont, which have been shown to be in Italy. And the time of the play is 16th century. The setting is 16th century. Now let's come to the trial scene. Before we start writing the importance of the trial scene, we need to look at the background of the scene. So basically, background means what happened before the trial scene. How did Antonio and Shylock land in the court? How did the trial scene begin? What was behind the trial scene? So the background goes like this. As we all know that Antonio fails to pay back the debt that he had taken from Shylock. And as per the conditions of the bond that they had signed, Shylock is entitled to take a pound of flesh from his body. Now, again, before starting the importance of the scene, you will need to write the summary of the scene. What all happens in the trial scene? What is the sequence of events that unfolds in the trial scene? So the scene begins with the Duke requesting Shylock to show mercy to Antonio. We all have seen that the Duke uses ornated language to appeal to Shylock that you should show some mercy to Antonio, and you know, you how will you expect people to show mercy to you when you don't show some to others? And then we see that Shylock, as we all know, is unrelenting, and he refuses to show any kind of mercy, and he's hell-bent. He's bent upon just taking the bond. And then we see Portia enters the court disguised as a lawyer in place of Dr. Valerio. She also appeals to Shylock for mercy and delivers the famous quality of mercy speech. So you can write all these points in detail. You can elaborate on these points. She also admits to the bond being legal and allows Shylock to cut the pound of flesh. And then she brings out the catch that no drop of blood should be shed while cutting the flesh, because no such mention is there in the bond. The bond only mentions a pound of flesh and no blood. So we see tables are turned upon Shylock and he's not allowed to get even his principal amount. Shylock is charged with attempt to threaten the life of a Venetian, and his property is confiscated and he's asked to convert to Christianity. So this is the summary of the scene. This is what happens in the scene. Now let's come to the importance of the scene. Why is the scene so important? What is the dramatic importance of the trial scene? It is the most dramatic scene in the play. We all know what do you mean by dramatic? Dramatic means two things. One is related to drama, and the other meaning is that when something happens so suddenly, you know, and abruptly, we call it, and it is striking, we call it dramatic. So that you all have seen that the tension is at its peak in the scene and has a lot of unexpected turn of events, developments that no one can anticipate what is going to happen. It is also marked by sudden and striking twists and turns. The entire scene is filled with, you know, replete with events that we cannot expect. Bassanio comes to with the money and he offers him thrice the money. And Shylock refuses to take the money. And he says, I will only charge, I only want my bond. And then he even sharpens the knife from which he wants to use to cut the pound of flesh from Antonio's body. So all this happens, and then suddenly there is a twist that Portia comes up with, that the bond only mentions a pound of flesh, and there's no mention of a single drop of blood. So shed no blood. You can also quote from the text when you write these events. You can quote Portia's words, you can quote Shylock's words from the text, and you can write begin writing the dramatic importance of the trial scene. So it is the most dramatic scene. We see that the tension is at its peak, and we cannot expect what is going to happen. Antonio almost loses his life. He's on the verge of dying. Antonio and Bassanio have also, held their hands and for the last time, and they have had Antonio has had his last wish and last words, and then suddenly the tables are turned upon Shylock. So we can say that this is very dramatic. It is marked by sudden and striking twists and turns. Now, another important thing about the trial scene is that it is a culmination of the subplot. Now, the subplot is a Bond story. The main plot is Portia and Bassanio's love interest and marriage. And the subplot was a story within the story, which resulted out of the main plot, and which was a signing of the bond between Antonio and Shylock. So we see that trial scene is a culmination of the subplot. Here is when the subplot, the bond story, ends. It comes to its end. The subplot reaches its climax here in the trial scene, and we see that Antonio's life is saved. It also acts as a connector between the main plot and subplot. Now, how is that? Portia is a lead character from the main plot, and she saves the life of Antonio, who is the lead character of the subplot. So here we see that the trial scene basically works as a connector between the two plots. It is a link between the two plots, and it shows that these two plots are interdependent. It shows their interdependence also. So that's how it is important. Another point is that we see Portia and Shylock, the two main characters who have never met before the trial scene. They are one of the most important characters of the play, and they do not meet each other before the trial scene. So trial scene becomes important because this is where Portia and Shylock, the two main characters, meet for the first time. It results in the development of the ring episode also, which further results in light-hearted comedy, qualifying the play as a romantic comedy. We see that it is at the end of the trial scene when the ring episode begins, in lieu of saving the life of Antonio, Portia and Nerissa, they demand from Bassanio and Gratiano the rings that their wives had given them. And though reluctantly, they had to part with the rings. And that is where the ring episode, which is a very comic episode of the play, it results here. It results in light-hearted comedy, and you know what qualifies any play as a romantic comedy? There has to be romance and there has to be comedy. So romance, as we know, that play has three couples. We have Bassanio and Portia, we have Nerissa and Gratiano, and we have Lorenzo and Jessica. So we have romance and we have comedy. One of the most comic scenes of the play, one of the most comic scenes is the ring episode, which results from the trial scene. So that's why the trial scene becomes important, and the ring scene has a lot of comedy. So it is one of the factors because of which the play can be qualified as a romantic comedy. So that's why the trial scene becomes even more important. Then it also throws light on the characters of Shylock and Portia. So we see that Portia, we see the intelligence, wisdom, and wit of Portia, and we see Shylock as a very savage person who's not ready to show any kind of mercy on Antonio, and his revengefulness is shown at its peak in the trial scene. So we a little bit of light is thrown on these two characters also in this scene. Also, the idea of justice. There's a conflict between the idea of justice in the two religions. We have seen that the two religions in question here are Judaism and Christianity. According to Judaism, which is represented here by Shylock, justice means punishing bad people. So he's hell-bent on punishing Antonio. He doesn't want to show any kind of mercy. He's unrelenting. And he says, I have to take my revenge. Christianity, on the other hand, is shown to have a softer approach to justice in this play. They are shown to have belief in mercy, which is shown when the Duke says that before even Shylock asks for it, I forgive him. You know, I forgive, I grant his life. So they are shown to be more merciful and more soft. You know, their approach to justice, towards justice, is softer than the Judaism. So we see this conflict of the idea of between the idea of justice in this trial scene. It also shows that idea of justice in Christianity is better. That is also the idea behind the trial scene. Justice versus mercy debate that we had in the class. Now, you all must remember that. I'm sure you remember that. That we discussed that both the Duke and Portia are focusing on the point that Shylock definitely deserves justice. You know, his bond is legal. But if we only seek justice, we cannot, none of us should see salvation. That's what Portia says. So we have to show mercy also. Justice, it is basically justice versus mercy. If you seek justice, of course, you will get it, Shylock, Portia says to Shylock, but then a person will lose his life. So you have to show some mercy also. So this justice versus mercy debate gets highlighted here in the trial scene. Some other points of this play, this trial scene being so important are, it is famous for its very strong dialogues. Some of the most famous speeches in the history of English literature are delivered here. One of them being The Quality of Mercy by Portia, and she delivers a speech, and it became so famous that it is taught in some universities and colleges as an independent poem. And also one point that I would like to make here is that this trial scene also shows the feminist side of Shakespeare. Portia is disguised as a man to solve the case. She enters the court. It was during a time when women were not allowed in the courts. So I think Shakespeare, by showing Portia to be the lawyer and disguised as a man and going to solve the case where all men are failing, Portia delivers justice. She comes to the rescue. I think Shakespeare shows some liberal thought related to the position of women in 16th century by projecting Portia as a role model, for those women. She goes to the court and solves the case. So I think that's also another very important point. And this is the end of our points. You can all just write these, elaborate these points and write a detailed answer to this question, the importance of trial scene in the play The Merchant of Venice. Thank you.